Okay, so three hands are raised. Yes, Salama, you tell me. Salama, you tell me. Features of the body, member of body. Okay. बेटा लेट हर कंप्लीट यस Okay. Yes, you're good. Yes. Who was saying that? Umar. Yes, Umar, tell me. Umar? Yes, Umar, you can tell. So, member of Porifera. Okay. Quickly, quickly. Yes. Okay, sponges. So means porifera, the most important point related to porifera that they are the simplest multicellular organism. Here tissue organization is not there. They do not have any cavity, true cavity in the body. Means cavities are the spaces where the organ systems are fit. So they do not have true cavities in the body. Means they do not have organ systems. So the cavities are also not there. The body is made up of cells and every cell do their its own means function as a tissue system or the organ system organization is not there. Tissue organization is not there. This is the important, most important point related to sponges. And of course, they're having the pores all over the body and through which the water and nutrients enter in the body and cells utilize those nutrients and water and excretory substances and an extra water and nutrient, they just excrete it out through the central pore, the large central pore. So this is all about porifera. Then nidaria or coelenterata. Another name for the nidaria is coelenterata. So just raise your hand and tell me what are the features of member of nidaria. Yes. Yes. Features of nidaria or coelenterata. Yes, tell me. soft. And they have? Yes. Yes. One that Now, Haya, you tell me. Haya, you tell me features of Nideria. Am I audible? Haya, am Mariam Khan? Mariam Khan, feature of the member of Nideria. Tell me quickly. Mariam Khan. Afshan, you tell me. Okay, good. Okay, what are the what is the function of tentacle? Yes, Anam. What is the feature of tentacle? Tentacles. Okay, yes, very good. Okay, Ilma Danish. Ilma Danish. Ariba Fatma. Ariba Fatma. Fariha Javed. Fariha Javed. Yes, Fariha Javed. Tell me features of Plateae helminthes. Member of Plateae helminthes. Yes, Fariha Javed. Tell me some features of the member of Plateae helminthes. Flatworms. Yes. Yes, Faria Javed. Yes, features of platy helminthes. Okay, well, that's good. So platy helminthes, they are the flatworm, and the most what you can say, the specific feature of the member of this category, they are flat, leaf like or ribbon like. Another specific feature is that they have one opening. They act as mouth as well as anus. Means that opening is used for take the food in, and for the expulsion of waste also, to get it the waste from the body. Means the same opening. And they have hooks and suckers so that they can attach to the host body for sucking the nutrient from the body. Then what are the features of nematodes? Raise your hand. Yes, Muhammad Umar. Muhammad Umar. Yes, they are parasites, and platy helminthes also parasites. Okay, so they are they having what special feature they have? Their body is cylindrical. Their body long, thin, and cylindrical, and their body unsegmented body is there. So they have cylindrical unsegmented body. They are parasite. They have the two openings, one act as mouth and one as a anus. Means at one end it is mouth and another end has anus, and they have a tube like digestive system also. Means they have a two digestive system. So one end of the digestive system is mouth, one opening having mouth as a mouth. Another end of the digestive system is having an opening on the other end, that is called anus. So they have two openings. Now annelida. Annelida, annuli means segments. So annelida means segmented worm. Segmented worm means they having the ring like segments on the body. So ring like segments are known as annuli, and because of annuli they are known as segmented worm. So they are mostly free living worm, and they live in soil and water. So they are like I told you, flatworm and roundworm, they are parasite, but annelids, they are free living worms. They can be found in soil, they can be found in water. And they have bristles like a structure called cheeti on the lower surface, and that helpful in locomotion. They also have two opening, and they having the digestive system. They are having what you can say excretory organ also. So they having the body cavity also, that is called coelom. Annelids having body cavity called coelom. Okay, so now let's move to the arthropod. Arthropod also, I think I have done it. Yes. Yes, last turn we have done it. Arthropod means about 80% of the animal kingdom. Constitute the animal kingdom constituted by 80% arthropod, and they can be terrestrial or aquatic. The body have a hard outer covering or exoskeleton made up of chitin. Made up of chitin. So their body divided into three or you can say part, head, thorax and abdomen. And they having the jointed legs. Jointed legs, the legs are having the visible joints. So they having jointed legs. Usually in three pairs for the locomotion. And arthropod have antennae also for the as a sensory organ, and they have compound eyes. They have compound eyes means many lenses are there in one eye. So this is all about arthropod. Then mollusca. I think I remember mollusca also done. So they having the mollusca is I will show you. This is a mollusca also can be, you know, found on land as well as on water. So they can be terrestrial or aquatic. So here, this is member. This is snail and a member of mollusca, and they have soft, unsegmented body, as you can see here. This is unsegmented body. Segments are not there. They having the visceral mass, head, and the muscular foot. This is muscular foot. This is head. And here inside this shell is the visceral mass, and this is shell. So they having the three part, that is head, muscular foot, and the visceral mass. And they have hard shell that covers their body. At the time of danger, they withdraw their body inside the shell. They protect at the time of danger. By taking the shelter by this shell, what you can say, shell. So this is all about this is the body. This is all about the mollusk, that their body is also categorized into three part. Head. Here I'll show you again. This is head. This is head. This is muscular foot. With the help of it, it moves. And inside this shell, this is shell from outside. Inside this shell, visceral mass is there. So, muscular foot helpful in locomotion. An example of mollusk, oyster, mussels, and the snail. So what are the main features of the mollusk? That they have the hard covering around it, that is called shell, and the body is divided into three parts. Head, visceral mass, and the muscular foot. Now echinodermata. Yes, you raised hand. Yes, why you people raise hand, want to ask something? Some hands are raised, want to ask something? Anyway, echinodermata. Echinodermata are marine animals, and they have a tough skin body covered with spines. एंड द बॉडी यूजुअली हैज सेंट्रल डिस्क फ्रॉम विच फाइव और मोर आर्म्स रेडिएट आउटवर्ड गिविंग देम अ स्टार लाइक अपियरेंस. सो इकाइनोडर्म्स आर मरीन एनिमल. दे हैव अ टफ स्किन बॉडी कवर्ड विद स्पाइन, मीन दे हैविंग द स्पाइंस ऑल ओवर द बॉडी. दे हैविंग द टफ स्किन अराउंड इट, मीन्स लाइक वेन वी टॉक अबाउट मोरस देयर बॉडी इज सॉफ्ट. वेन यू टॉक अबाउट वॉर्म्स लाइक प्लेटीहेलमिंथीज एनेलिड्स और द निमेटोड्स, देयर बॉडी इज सॉफ्ट. Their body is soft, mollusk body is soft, but when you talk about Echinodermata, their body is tough because they are having the spines on the skin. And their body usually has central disc from which five or more arms radiate outward, giving them a star-like appearance, like a starfish. From the central disc, the arms are radiated. They can be five or more. And there's a mouth on the lower side of the body and anus on the upper side of the body. So mouth on the lower surface, and so that they can get the food easily from the water, and anus on the upper surface of the disc, you can say, or the body. So they excrete out waste from the body through the anus. So and these animals move with the help of a special tube-like structure. They are known as tube feet, means they having the small tube-like structure. And at the end of the tube-like structure, suckers are also attached. So these suckers are used to attach with the surfaces to suck the nutrient from the body. Where they attach two feet, they helpful in the locomotion. So they help with the help of they move with the help of two feet. Mean the locomotory organ. If someone asks of the echinodermis, they are the two feet. So what are the feature of the echinodermis? I told you, most of them they are marine. So the echinodermata also marine, and we just talk about porifera, they are marine, and cnidaria also they are marine. And when we talk about worms like flatworm, roundworm, so they are parasite, and segmented worm, that is free living, can be found in soil and water. And mollusks, they can be both type. They can be terrestrial or aquatic. So they can be categorized in the aquatic and terrestrial. Some of the member of the mollusk are aquatic, some of the member of the mollusk are terrestrial. And echinodermata, they are also found in marine water. Marine water means salty water. So they are what they have. They have the central disc. What are the features they have? Just repeat in your heart. They have a central disc. From the central disc, only the different arms are radiated. They can be having five or the more than this arm, and they having the mouth on the lower surface. What is the point related to the echinoderm? That they have mouth. They have opening. At the lower surface and the upper surface both, but the mouth is on the lower surface so that they can get the food easily from the water, and they having the anus on the upper surface to get rid the waste. So these and then locomotory organ of the echinoderms are 2 feet. With the help of this they are moving, and they having the suckers also, so that they just what you can say attached to the surface of the host or the surface of the body, and from where they get the nutrient, so they suck the nutrient from the animals from which they derive the nutrient. Means they suck, they just what you can they attach with the help of sucker, and they suck the nutrient from the animals, different other animals, you can say. Now vertebrates in vertebrate we have done all 8 category. We have done porifera, cnidaria, Platyhelminthes, Nematoda, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, all are done. And now we are starting vertebrates. Before that, there is an exercise. Observe the figure and answer the question on the page number 63. So, identify and name the organism 1 to 4. What is the common characteristic feature of all these organisms? So, what is the common... Yes? Identify and name the organism 1, 2, 4. First one, Porifera. Second one. Means Porifera or sponges. Sponges, you can... You can see sponge. First one is sea sponge. Second one is jellyfish. Third one, yes, earthworm. And the fourth one, honeybee. Yes. The what is the common characteristic feature of all these organisms? They all are heterotrophs. Common feature. And they cannot make their own food like plants. They just all are heterotroph. They have to depend on other to get the food. Yes? Yes? Yes?
Yes?
What, beta? Body cavity, you can say. The body mass. The mass which is there inside the shell. That is visceral cavity. Okay, body cavity. What? They are body covered with spines. Yes, spines, you are asking. Tough. It is tough.
Tough.
This is the category of division. Means how we just, I think, studied in the beginning. Classification we studied. Have we discussed now? That is species, genus, family, order, class, phylum, kingdom. That is. Nematoda and Annelida. Both are worm, but Annelida is unsegmented because of the ring-like segments found on their body. And nematodes, they have unsegmented body. And nematodes are, what you can say, having a tube-like digestive system. But they having a little advanced, like they having the body cavity also, Annelida, and they having the excretory organ also. So... this is the difference between both. That the main difference in between both that segmented worms are the Annelida and they are unsegmented worm. They are cylindrical unsegmented worm nematodes. And the another main difference is that nematodes are the parasite and annelids they are free living. Free living worms means they can be found in soil. They can be found in water. And another difference, they have the bracelet-like structure on the lower surface of the body in Annelida, not in the nematodes. Nematode bracelets are not there. What is the relationship? Means what are the same features? How they are related to each other? They are just worm. They are long, thin, cylindrical body. They both are long cylindrical body, and they categorized as worm only, nematode also, annelida also, and they having the both two openings. Both are having the two openings. One is mouth, one is anus. Yes, this you want. Yes. Yes. Annelids are segmented. Both are not segmented. Annelids are only segmented. Okay. Barakallah. So now here we were discussing the what is the common characteristic feature? They all are heterotroph. Right, third, right, one difference between 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1 and 2 means Porifera. The most important difference is that they do not have tentacle porifera, and the cnidaria jellyfish, they have tentacles. And the another difference is that that porifera having the pore around the body, and cnidarians are having the only one opening in the center. So that act as for both to get the food in or to excrete out the waste. So these are the differences. And third and fourth also, third is earthworm and fourth is arthropod. Many differences you can write, like no, it's not earth annelids. I think this is a round worm. A smooth body is visible. So here the body is unsegmented in three. It's not segmented, but I don't. It seems like smooth only. A smooth body, unsegmented. Yeah. Okay, if it's very much clear that this is a smooth body. Yes, what do you think about it? How many are saying it is a smooth body, it's an unsegmented body, or segmented body? Just tell me, raise your hands for the name. It's segmented. How many are saying segmented? How many are saying unsegmented? Raise your hand. This is 3 and 4. Three picture three. That is on the page number 63. Exercises there. Questions. They are. Anyway, if it is segmented, then also see the difference that the body is divided into three parts in the arthropod that had thorax and abdomen. Here, the body is having the ring-like segments. The body is not divided into three parts like head, thorax and abdomen. It's having the ring-like segments. This is the difference you can write. Or you can write this also, that they are annelids, or annelids having the cylindrical body, and this arthropod having the body divided into three parts. Or you can write this also, arthropod having antennae as a sensory organ. So they do not have antennae. Annelids or the nematode, they do not have. Yes. You can write arthropoda, means segments. So you can, means it's divided into the three parts, but they having the segments That is also you can say it's segmented into three parts. Here the same, the difference is that they having the many ring-like segments all over the body in the annelid. But in arthropod, they having the specific three, the body divided into specific three parts. Head, thorax, and abdomen. Otherwise, you can write the... Listen, you can write antennae difference. You can write compound eye difference. You can write jointed leg difference. A lot of differences are there between annelids and the arthropod. So means no. They asking the difference. What is the difference between two? So you have to write difference. Like you have to write like arthropod not having the compound eye, and what you can say arthropod having the compound eye. Arthropod having antennae and arthropod not having arthropod or annelid not having antennae. Like this you have to write one difference. They are asking. State the phyla of each animal. Here you have to write phyla. That is means like what is the phyla of this first one is sponges, Porifera. For the second one is yes. Who is it? Phyla, you tell me. Phyla, you tell me. Second one phyla is. Yes. So second one is Cnidaria or Coelenterata. Third one is Annelida. Fourth one is Arthropoda. Fourth one is Arthropoda. So now we'll start vertebrates. So there are five prominent group of animal under vertebrates. Means vertebrates are categorized into five broad categories. Like invertebrates are categorized into eight broad categories. I discussed you all the eight categories like Porifera, Coelenterata, Cnidaria, Platyhelminthes, and Nematoda, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata. They are the eight category of the invertebrate. Now vertebrates having five categories, five groups. You can say the animal, all vertebrates are categorized into five broad categories. That is pisces or fish. First category is pisces or fish. Second is amphibian. Third is reptile. And fourth is birds or apes. And fifth is mammal. So, vertebrates are categorized into five categories. Now, let's start with the pisces. Now, pisces, here fact file is there. Pisces is broadly categorized into two types, bony fish and whose skeleton is made up of bones. And another is cartilaginous fish, whose skeleton is soft, flexible and made up of cartilage. So, two type of... fishes are there, bony and the cartilaginous fish. Bony fish is having the bony skeleton, cartilaginous fish is having the cartilage, skeleton made up of cartilage, that is flexible. So there's example also given in this, that like rohu is bony fish and shark is the cartilaginous fish. Now let's start the feature of the pisces or the fish. We know the features of fish, like fish is aquatic animal. Fish can be found in ocean as well as river. It can be found in marine water. It can be found in fresh water. And they have scaly streamlined body. Streamlined body, what does it mean? That their body is just from the front it is narrow and from the middle it is broad. So means it cuts the current of water easily. So because they have to live in water.